هيا على الفلاح هيا على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له رب العالمين وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد عبده ورسوله المبعوث رحمة للعالمين صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers His fadl and karam upon us in various different ways. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from amongst His many blessings, is this great month of Ramadan. This is an opportunity Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is granting us to come close to Him, to draw near to Him. And this is an excuse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us to secure our maghfirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to forgive His servants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafoorur Rahim, the forgiving, the merciful. His mercy has no bounds. His forgiveness has no bounds. Inna rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. My mercy extends to everything in existence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. My mercy extends to everything in existence. He is the one al-wadood, who is the one who has love, who has so sincere love, genuine love for His servants, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, giving the example that the love the mother has. Please, inshallah, the directions, if you can give it quietly, Imran Bhai. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His love for His servants is so much that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that giving the example of the love of the mother, Rasulullah ta'ala, His love for His servants is greater than the love of 70 mothers. And this servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bent upon his bringing upon himself his own destruction by disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by fulfilling his desires. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to bring the servant back. So He gives different excuses and different ways to call the servant back. And one of these greatest means of calling the servant back is this month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum al-siyam, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqun. O those who believe, fasting has been prescribed upon you. What is the purpose of this siyam? Kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, similar to, likewise, as it was prescribed upon people prior to you, la'allakum tattaqun, so that you may develop taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to become amongst the muttaqeen and wants us to have the best ending. وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The best ending are for those who have taqwa. And He wants us to be among those muttaqeen. And that is why He has brought this month of fasting upon us. And this fast that we are engaged in, this is an exercise for us to become cognizant and realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always with us and is always watching our actions. Inna Allah ma'i yarani wa isma'u kalami. Verily Allah is with me. He sees me in all conditions and He hears my words. Whatever I am saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is listening to everything that I am saying. This realization can be developed through fasting. How so? Because while a person is fasting, at all times, he has the habit throughout the day, whenever he's thirsty, to drink water, whenever he's hungry, to grab a bite. But when he is in the state of fasting, he will never do so. Yusuf bhai. So this is something that is, we are continually being reminded while we are fasting, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching. There is no one who has even a shred of iman, iota of iman, who will, na'udhu billah, cheat in his fast. No one will do that. Even children will not do that. Why not? Because we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. Now this same realization that Allah is watching us, we have to develop throughout our lives. This same concept that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna rabbaka labil mirsad, verily your Lord is closely watching over you. Alam ya'lam bi anna Allah yara. Do you not realize that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching? If we can develop this, subhanallah, then we are successful. Then we are successful. We will be among the successful ones. We will not be disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the reality of what taqwa is. Taqwa sometimes is translated as fear of Allah. It is not fear the way a person is afraid of his enemy, or the way a person is afraid of something that is harmful, that this person or this snake, this scorpion may bite me, may hurt me, this enemy may attack me. Na'udhu billah. We are not afraid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do any injustice upon us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ النَّاسَ شَيْئًا. Verily Allah will never commit any zulm upon anyone. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ النَّاسَ شَيْئًا وَلَكِنَّ النَّاسَ أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. People are doing zulm and oppression upon themselves. So, we are not afraid of Allah in that regard. The only thing we are afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that we will be incurring His anger, we will be incurring His wrath. That is what you are afraid of. And we do not want to be disobeying Him. And this sense, this reality of this sense is called taqwa. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can grant us if we fast in the correct manner. So this is something which Allah ta'ala says clearly in the Quran, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The purpose of fasting is to increase your taqwa. And we need to do a check of ourselves as we are continuing through this fast of Ramadan. Is our taqwa level increasing? If we find that our taqwa level is not increasing, then that means, is there something wrong with the word of Allah? Absolutely not. There must be something wrong with our fast. We are not fasting in a manner that would bring about the full benefits. Because fasting is not a sawm junnah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fasting is a shield that will protect you from your nafs and shaitan. Malam yakhruqha, as long as you do not break your shield. How can you be breaking your shield? That yes, you may be abstaining from eating and drinking and marital relations, but you are not abstaining from looking at haram. You're not abstaining from listening to haram. You're not abstaining from imagining, fantasizing, na'udhu billah, about haram. Speaking haram, backbiting, wasting time in futile efforts and futile things. So these things will take away the benefit of that fast. And the level of taqwa which was desired to be created through that fast will not be obtained. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has warned us. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a bashir and a nadir. Inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadira. He was a mubashir, a bringer of glad tidings, and at the same time he was a nadir, a warner. So we have in the hadith, we have the targhib and tarhib, warnings, tarhib and targhib, encouragements. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that man sama ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. And at the same time he said, kam min sa'imin laysa lahu min siyabihi illa al-ju' wal 'atash. So we have two opposing types of ahadith referring to two different types of fast. On one side, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, man sama ramadan, whoever fasts in the month of ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaban, with belief in iman and ihtisab, looking forward to the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity, then غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ, all of his past sins will be forgiven. Subhanallah. What could be a greater reward? All of the past sins forgiven. And on the other hand, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كَمْ مِنْ صَائِمٍ, how many people there are who are fasting? So many people are fasting. لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ صِيَامِ إِلَّا الْجُوعِ وَالْعَتَاشِ. The only thing they get to their benefit from their fast is hunger and thirst. Hunger and thirst. That's it. That's all they get. Na'udhu billah. They have nothing else to their credit. May Allah protect us from such an outcome. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in our fast and accept our fast. Make us from the utaqa'i Ramadan, those who are forgiven in the month of Ramadan, and make us among the muttaqeen. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Let us perform sunnah inshallah.
You have some few important announcements, inshallah. Please note that every Friday we have a youth qiyam, brothers youth qiyam, youth program at night after Tarawih Salah with different guest speakers. So tonight we have Maulana Asfaruddin, the Imam at Islamic Foundation North. He will be addressing the youth here to discuss how to make this the best Ramadan ever. And this will be a night program with the program after Tarawih, followed by basketball as well in the gym. And there will be arrangements for suhoor for the youth. There are many programs taking place here in MashaAllah Dar es Salaam in Ramadan. Please visit our website, masjiddiaz.org/Ramadan2021, about information of regarding our Ramadan programs. After Asr Salah, from Friday to Sunday, we have a tazkiyah talk by Maulana Zahid Chaudhry. Every day before Maghrib, we have dhikr and dua. This is on-site as well as online. We have the daily iftar that is served here. After Tarawih, we have two tafsir sessions, one here in the main hall and one for the Tarawih that is taking place in the gymnasium. We have the Zakat seminar, Fiqh of Zakat, as this is the month where we discharge our Zakat. This will be held on Sunday, April 25th. And we have sisters programs online and on-site, Monday to Friday after Dhuhr Salah. Please sign up for the i'tikaf, those who are interested to perform the sunnah of i'tikaf last 10 days of Ramadan at masjiddiaz.org/i'tikaf2021. And lastly, we have this campaign. I would like to speak a few minutes about this before the salah. A very, very important campaign that we want to complete by Eid Salah, inshallah, by Eid Day. And this is the Fortunate 1400 campaign. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given all of us different abilities, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us about those abilities, what we have done to secure His pleasure. And all of us are doing the khidmah of deen in various different ways. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has selected certain individuals to study the deen and to become students of knowledge, dedicated students of knowledge. This is not an obligation upon everyone to dedicate their lives fully to study the ilm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ لِيَتَفَقَّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. One group should dedicate themselves to gain deep understanding of the deen. وَلِيُنْذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ إِذَا رَجَعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْذَرُونَ. And their responsibility is to guide and educate the rest of the people. So alhamdulillah, here at Dar es Salaam Seminary, we have students of knowledge and teachers who are dedicated to serving the sacred sciences and preserving this deen and serving as, inshallah, imams and scholars throughout America. So this is, alhamdulillah, our national campus, which has reached completion. The construction is done through your efforts, through your generous donations, through your du'as, through your well-wishing, mashallah, help and support. Now, alhamdulillah, we have this state-of-the-art facility, which you are free at all times to visit and to tour, and I'm sure you have. The question is, how are we going to maintain this? And how are we going to keep up with all of the additional expenses? So for this, we are asking, alhamdulillah, if we can have 1,400 people sign up for recurring monthly donations for the upkeep and maintenance of this great seminary, this national campus. And the 1,400 number is tafa'ulan, to get the good omen and barakah of this beautiful number of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in, who pledged on the hands of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam that they will defend the deen at all costs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this pledge in the Quran. لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with the believers. إِذْ يُبَايِعُونَكَ تَحْتَ شَجَرَةٍ. When they took the pledge on your hand under the tree of Hudaybiyah. فَعَلِمَ مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. Allah was aware of the sincerity in their hearts. فَأَنزَلَ السَّكِينَةَ عَلَيْهِمْ. And Allah sent down His special mercy upon them. وَأَثَابَهُمْ فَتْحًا قَرِيبًا. And He promised them that they will have near victory. وَمَغَانِمَ كَثِيرَةً يَأْخُذُونَهَا. And they will have great spoils of war that they will take. This spoils of war, this victory is not in Jannah, it's starting from this dunya itself. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam addressed them. As Jabir bin Abdullah radiallahu anhu says, Kunna yawm al-Hudaybiyyati alfan wa arba'amiyah. On the day of Hudaybiyah, Jabir bin Abdullah radiallahu anhu says, we were 1,400 sahaba. فَقَالَ لَنَا النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَنْتُمَ الْيَوْمَ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. He said to us, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O you 1,400, you are the best people on the surface of the earth. So inshallah, following in the footsteps of these 1,400 and hoping to be resurrected with them, we are requesting 1,400 individuals to sign up for recurring pledge to support the seminary. So inshallah, on this first Jumu'ah of Ramadan, do we have some Mubarak blessed people who Allah Ta'ala accepts to be among the fortunate 1400? So do we have anyone, inshallah, raise your hand, inshallah, to be among these 1400? Please give your names, inshallah. Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Takbir. Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah, we have another brother here. Takbir. Allahu Akbar. So that's two, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, we want to reach the 1400 by end of Ramadan. Please take this message to your heart and please spread this message amongst others. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ughdu aliman, aw muta'alliman, aw mustami'an, aw muhibban, wa la takun al-khamis fatahlik." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Become a scholar yourself, or become a dedicated student of knowledge, or become a part-time student of knowledge, or become a patron and supporter of the students of knowledge. And do not be in any fifth category." These are the four options we have: to become a scholar or full-time student, part-time student, or supporter of students of knowledge. So inshallah, let us see who are amongst us who inshallah will be among the fortunate 1400. We have a few hands came up, and a few more, and then we'll start the khutbah inshallah. Any more, anyone, brother, inshallah. Ash-shaytanu ya'idukum al-faqr. Shaitan will be promising you poverty. وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. In the money that you withhold, he will ensure you spend it in the wrong ways. Alright? وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِنْهُ وَفَضَلًا. Allah will promise forgiveness and bounty in return. This is the sign of Iman, the one who gives sadaqah, and this is the season of sadaqah, the month of Ramadan. This is the month where مَنْ أَدَّى فَرِيضَةً فِيهِ كَانَ كَمَنْ أَدَّى سَبْعِينَ فَرِيضَةً فِي مَا سِوَى. Fulfilling an obligation in this month will get 70 times. Imagine, buy one, get 70. And if you fulfill a nafal, inshallah, the reward of a farad. So this is not something we should just hear in one ear and ear out the other ear. But this is something that we should participate in. Allah Ta'ala selected us to be among those who are visiting here and who are praying here and benefiting from the programs here. So it's also, it's opportune that we invest back in that which we are benefiting from. So do we have any last few hands? And if you, last few hands, I have a time limit. I have to start the salah. Any last few hands, inshallah, we can make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the brothers who raise their hands. May Allah ta'ala give them more and more barakah. May Allah ta'ala protect them from all calamities and balaya, masaib. May Allah ta'ala bless them and their children. Make the children ulama and khuddam of the deen. And fulfill all of their, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill all of their permissible desires. Say ameen inshallah. On this blessed day of Jumu'ah, we make dua for all of these brothers and for everyone inshallah as well. Those who sign up, those who listen patiently, those who make dua, and those who wish well in their hearts. The dua is for everyone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant everyone barakah. But we see from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who stood up and gave his name. There was one occasion where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, after they were marching and marching and marching, and they were tired in the campaign and the expedition, and they finally wanted to sit down and rest. He said, "Who's ready to guard tonight?" So one sahabi got up and gave his name, raised his hand. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought him forward, grabbed his shirt, in the front part of his shirt, and made so much dua for him. And then one sahabi got very excited about that, and then he said, "I want that dua as well." So he raised his hand and he narrates the hadith. He said, "Rasulullah made some dua for me too, but he did not make as much as he did for the first one." Because wasabiqun as-sabiqun, those who raise their hands first, that is the high rank Allah has given them. Who wants to be among the sabiqun? Inshallah, anyone else wants to raise their hands inshallah and gain the duas? The duas of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept everyone. Please keep this in your mind. If you're not ready to commit today, but before the end of Ramadan, we kindly request everyone here to become part of the fortunate 1400. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah, ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Hayya 'alas salah, hayya 'alas salah, حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله الحمد لله حمد الشاكرين ونؤمن به إيمان الموقنين
ونقر بوحدانيته قرار الصادقين ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له رب العالمين ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله الصادق الأمين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان ودعا بدعوتهم واستنى بسنتهم واقتدى بهديهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في محكم تنزيله بعد أن أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فيا أحبتي في الله اتقوا الله اتقوا الله سبحانه وتعالى في السر والعلن وذروا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن وحافظوا على الجمع والجماعة ووطنوا أنفسكم على السمع والطاعة واعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في محكم تنزيله بعد أن أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون أياما معدودات فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون وقال النبي صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وسلم من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام كم من صائم ليس له من صيامه إلا الجوع والعطش وكما قال صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وسلم صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله نشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى قد أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه ثم ثنى بملائكته المسبحة لقدسه ثم ثلث بكم أيها المؤمنون من برية جنه وإنسه حيث قال ولم يزل قائلا كريما تعظيما لشان حبيبه وتبجيلا وتكريما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد قال النبي صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وسلم أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر صاحب رسول الله في الغار وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر قامع أساس الكفار وأصدقهم حياء عثمان صاحب الحياء والوقار وأقضاهم علي المرتضى أسد الله الجبار رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وتقبل ركوعنا وسجودنا وتقبل تبرعاتنا يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعلنا من عتقاء رمضان يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعلنا ممن وفق بقيام ليلة القدر يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين واحفظ الإسلام والمسلمين وعز الإسلام والمسلمين يا رب العالمين اللهم اجمع كلمة المسلمين على الحق المبين واحمي حوضة الإسلام والمسلمين وانصرنا على أعدائك أعدائنا أعداء الدين يا رب العالمين عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأتم وأهم وأعظم وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقيموا الصلاة.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah, ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Hayya 'alas salah, hayya 'alas salah, hayya 'alal falah, hayya 'alal falah. Qad qamatis salah, qad qamatis salah. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
Please stand on the blue lines. Please cover our faces and noses with our masks. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. الله نور السماوات والأرض مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة
يخافون يوما تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله والله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
We have very sad news. One of our teachers, respected teachers, Mawlana Muhyiddin, who does the Saturday morning program of Ihya Ulumuddin, his father just passed away today, a few hours ago. Let's make dua for marhum, as well as all of those beloved ones who were with us last Ramadan are not with us this year, and those that are still sick. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'mineen wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareebun mujibud da'awat. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وانثانا اللهم من احييت منا فاحيه على الاسلام ومن توفيت منا فتوفه على الايمان اللهم اجعل قبورهم روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعلها حفرا من حفر النار يا رب العالمين اللهم ثبتهم عند سؤال منكر النكير يا رب العالمين اللهم لا تحرمنا أجرهم ولا تفتنا بعدهم يا رب العالمين Oh Allah, forgive all of the deceased ones, يا رب العالمين Oh Allah, forgive the father of our beloved teacher, يا رب العالمين Oh Allah, all those near and dear ones, family members that we are missing this Ramadan passed away during this year or before Oh Allah, fill their graves with nur, يا رب العالمين Allow us to prepare for death before it strikes us as well, يا رب العالمين Oh Allah, none of us can escape this death, يا رب العالمين We all have to return to you, O Allah. Make us among those who are ready to return to you before the time comes, Ya Rabbil Alameen. O Allah, those that are still sick, O Allah, grant them shifa, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Subhana Rabbika Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifun. Wa Salamun Ala Al-Mursaleen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We have one brother who's going to take Shahada today, inshallah. So we have a brother who will be taking the Shahada. This brother is going to be ready to accept Islam. Please raise your hand and say with me, Ashhadu
Allah
إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله.
I testify
that there is no one worthy of worship besides
Allah.
And
I testify
that
Muhammad
is
messenger
and prophet.
Takbir.
MashaAllah, welcome to Islam.
MashaAllah.
Congratulations.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Rabbi shahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Subhanak la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. Subhanak la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. Subhanak la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. Amma ba'd. Respected elders and brothers, mothers and sisters, dear listeners, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. A very warm Ramadan Mubarak and a very warm welcome to the first Jum'ah in this blessed month of Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make every single day of ours and every single Jum'ah of ours of this blessed month extremely valuable and allow us to take full benefit from it. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. Dear brothers and sisters, the way this week has gone by, at a very fast pace, we're already losing count. How many days has it been? Similarly, the rest of the days also will be going at a very fast pace. And we need to ensure that we do not allow our work schedules, our job schedules, our study schedules to become so focal in our life that it makes us not appreciate and enjoy every blessing. Like when children are said, when they're given ice cream or a dessert, a very nice expensive dessert, you know, some of the high-end desserts, and they're served, they says, listen, don't just chug it down, don't just eat it all, enjoy every bite of it. It's not just a sweet or some sort of a lollipop. It's a very high-end French dessert, maybe, for example. Ramadan is like that. Every single aspect, every single second, there's something to benefit, there's something to enjoy, there's something to relish. But you have to be focused, and you have to be thinking what's going on right now. If a person just plows through it, then yeah, the days will get spent, the nights will get spent, and it will be done. Before you know it, it will be at Eid. That's true. But if a person wants to truly gain the full benefits of this blessed month, this would require a person to constantly be stopping himself and saying, what's happening? Today's a blessed day of Jummah. I've got 4 hours left in the day, 5 hours left in the day. What things have I done special in this Friday that I did not do last Friday? Besides not eating and drinking, besides that, what have I done today that sets my Friday apart from the previous Fridays of this year? That I can myself tell that I have spent this Friday and this Thursday night differently. Dear brothers and sisters, if that's not the case, then we're already losing. There must be something outstanding about the way we spend this day in terms of how we attend Jummah, in terms of what we do before, what we do after, that makes us all feel that this is definitely a very special Friday in the month of Ramadan. So one of those ways of ensuring that we get the most of it is that we dedicate a good amount of time every single time, every day, throughout the day in dua, supplication. And one of the Friday is a day of supplication, generally speaking, between Maghrib and Isha, between Asr and Maghrib, between the two khutbas, after the salah, on Thursday night. All of these are occasions when dua is accepted. And we have to value that. So if a person is going for an interview, how do we prepare our question answers to the questions beforehand? If a person is going for some sort of opportunity where we present our needs to someone who in power, we don't come and fiddle and pull out our phone and start figuring out what do I need to ask. We come up with that list in advance. Similarly, the time between Asr and Maghrib today is coming on Friday. And we want to make sure that we utilize every second of that as much as possible in dua. And so that is why the best way is that we come up with our list of things we can ask Allah from beforehand. This is the advice that we always have been told and we share with others, that those who are going for Umrah and Hajj, may Allah open up the doors for all of us to visit again soon. And for the Ummah to once again populate the Haramain al-Sharifain. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. But we encourage ourselves and others to prepare your list of du'as before you hit the journey. And if you haven't, you're sitting on the airplane, then at least take out your notebook, your phone, and start writing your list. So that you can start making this du'a as soon as you arrive. When you arrive and you look, your eyes fall upon the Haram al-Makki, and your eyes fall upon Ka'batullah, then you're not sitting there trying to think for what should I ask Allah for. You have already prepared your list of things that you want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. Isn't this the case? This is the advice we share. So my brothers and sisters, dear listeners, the month of Ramadan, this is our daily visit of the Kaaba. Every Maghrib is our daily view of the Kaaba. Every Suhoor time is our daily view of the Green Dome. What do I mean by that? That this is a very special moment when du'as are accepted. And a person needs to be prepared. A person needs to have that list of du'as that they're going to be making, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the good of this world and the next. Protection from the evil of this world and the next. The khair for the ummah, khair for our spouse, for our children, for our siblings and our parents. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam himself has taught us du'as. He has taught us ad'iyah to recite. Besides whatever we ask, these are some du'as that we should be reciting every single day at iftar time. This has been shared with all of us on our WhatsApp group, etc. And today, on your way out, you're going to receive this card. Inshallah, you can take as many as you need and share it with your family and friends. This has the list in a very nice, big, bold print. You can put it on your fridge. You can put it on your kitchen table. For all of our family members, to inshallah, to be reciting these du'as. Two du'as here. Before, prior to breaking the fast, we say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This is obviously with any food, with any meal, we're going to say Bismillah. The second dua, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi rahmatika allati wasi'at kulla shay' an taghfira li. O Allah, by the mercy, I ask you, Allahumma, O Allah, inni as'aluka, I ask you bi rahmatika, by your mercy, which encompasses everything. We are part of everything, are we not? We are things. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ Allah says, my rahmah encompasses everything. And all of us are part of those things. And our sins are part of those things. So we say, oh Allah, I ask you in the name of that mercy that encompasses everything, أَن تَغْفِرَ لِي, that you forgive me. I'm not asking something outlandish. I'm not asking something, you know, huge, great for you. This is what you do. You are forgiving. You're merciful. You love to forgive. You say the dua that we've been taught of Laylatul Qadr, probably all of us have memorized it. Allahumma innaka afu. Oh Allah, you're forgiving, kareem, you're generous. Tuhibbul afwa, you love to forgive. Fa'afu anni, so forgive me. So this is one of the du'as that we're going to recite. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and Allahumma inni as'aluka bi rahmatik. And then after we eat, before we pray our Maghrib Salah, we've broken our fast, now we're going to pray our Maghrib. Before we, what are the du'as? There are alhamdulillah four du'as listed here. And you have this card every day, inshallah, you can make a habit of reading it, and very soon you'll memorize it. Number one, ذهب الظمأ. Thirst is gone, alhamdulillah. وابتلت العروق. The veins are moistened with the drink. Now my body is hydrated. وثبت الأجر. And after the deed is done, if Allah wills, the reward has been established, inshallah. وثبت الأجر, inshallah, that I expect from Allah that my reward has been written for me in His, by him, and he will be giving it to me. Because now I did what I was supposed to do. I did my end of the deal. I fasted. I kept myself away, not only from food and drink, but from sins. Control my tongue, control my gaze, control my ears. Alhamdulillah, I did. Now it's paycheck time. I did my work. We did our end of the deal. This is the dua we're supposed to recite. But what do we say? Inshallah. Because we know my fast is nowhere where it needs to be. Too many flaws and mistakes in it. So now we are presenting this, that Ya Allah, we did what we're supposed to do, but we're hoping that our ajr is with you, and that you are not going to call us out on the mistakes, the countless mistakes that we had. Give us A for effort, as they say. Right? Give us A for the effort, and give us not what we deserve, but rather what matches your majesty and generosity. Second dua, Allahumma laka sumtu. O Allah, for you I have fasted. That's the beauty of fast, that there's huge amounts of sincerity in it. Who else are you fasting for if it's not for Allah? We could drink anytime we want. Why are we not? Because we're doing it for Allah. Allahumma laka sumtu, O Allah, I fasted for you. Wa ala rizqika aftartu. And O Allah, now I'm doing iftar, I'm breaking my fast. And with who, on whose tabs? On your tab. The food, whether I'm eating at your house, you're eating at my house, we're eating at the masjid. At the end of the day, this rizq is from Allah. So we're saying, Ya Allah, I'm breaking this fast also with the food that you have provided for me. Number three, Alhamdulillah alladhi a'anani. All praise is due to Allah who has assisted me. Allah has assisted me. So what was I able to do? Fasumtu. So I have fasted. How many elders are sitting here thinking that, you know, before Ramadan began, I was scared. Our elderly brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers, grandparents, they get scared before Ramadan is coming. How am I going to fast? But Alhamdulillah, through Allah's God-given strength that He has given us, alhamdulillah, we're able to fast. So many were wondering, how am I going to stand up for Taraweeh? But mashallah, they are doing it. Where is that strength coming from? Actually, we see the elderly have more strength than the youngsters. They're ready to stand in the 7-day Taraweeh. Come check out the 7-day Taraweeh that we have. Right? I think the average age is probably 60, 65. Right? They're standing for, you know, till 12:30 every single day. 4.5 juz. MashaAllah. Where did that physical strength come from? That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving them that spiritual strength which turns into physical strength for them to be able to stand up and pray the tarawih. So we say, Alhamdulillah alladhi a'anani. All praise is due to Allah who has assisted me. Fasumtu, so I have fasted. Warazaqani, and now He has provided me. Faaftartu, so I'm breaking my fast. So in my fast, I am obliged to thank You. And in breaking my fast, I'm also obliged to thank You. Whether I eat or I fast, in both instances, this is a blessing from You. In my not eating, this is the blessing of tawfiq that You have given me. And in my eating, this is the blessing of food that You have provided for me. And then the last dua to be recited after we finish eating our iftar and before we pray our maghrib is Allahumma laka sumna. O Allah, for You we have fasted. Wa ala rizqika aftarna. And we have broken our fast with Your sustenance. Fataqabbal minna. O Allah, please accept this from us. Accept it. Although it's not worthy, my dear friends, the word taqabbul intrinsically has a meaning in it, fitted inside it. What is that? Taqabbul is used for something which is not worthy of acceptance, but you're asking someone to accept it from you. Qabila yaqbal is accepted. That's why we don't say in the time of nikah, all of you attend a nikah. Have you ever heard this? The guy saying taqabbaltuha? Bhai mujhe nahi chahiye, lekin bas qubool kar leta hu. Taqabbaltuha, I don't want her, but I accept her. That doesn't happen, right? What do we say? Qabiltuha, I've accepted her very happily. I want her to be my wife. Qabiltuha. So qabila gives us the meaning of accepting. No strings attached. Taqabbala has the meaning of the fact of takalluf, that I don't want it, but you know, I'm doing it. So fataqabbal, oh Allah, it's not worthy of acceptance. I know it. I'm looking at the quality of it. It's radi, it's poor. But we're asking You to overlook my mistakes and accept it. Right? إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Indeed, You are all hearing. You're hearing my dua, all knowing. You know my intentions. Where do we get this dua from? The portion of it? This is the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam and Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. Father prophet, son prophet, the Khalilullah. Nabi s.a.w. calls him Abi, my father. He says, my father Ibrahim. That honorable individual, he has done the most beloved action, the most sublime action, that he's built the Kaaba with his son. The most amazing father and son project. What do you think? Right? Father and son building the Kaaba. And after they're done, they're turning to Allah and they're saying, Rabbana taqabbal minna. O Allah, please accept from us this deed which is not really worthy of acceptance. Me and my son are not the best. The quality of our work is not the best. But accept it. That is the humility and humbleness every single Muslim is supposed to have in front of Allah after any good deed, be it fasting, be it prayer, be it anything else. Hence, the last dua we all say in our tashahud before we say salam. Many of us at least say this. Allahumma inni dhulamtu nafsi. Allah, I've oppressed myself. You just finished Jummah. Why are you saying that? Allah, I've oppressed myself. A great oppression. La yaghfiru dhunuba illa anta. None can forgive my sins except for You. And then as soon as we say salam, what's the first thing we're supposed to all say? Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Yes? That's what we're supposed to say. As soon as we say salam, the first thing we say is astaghfirullah before we ask Allah for anything. Why are we doing istighfar after salam? Because the quality we know is horrible. So that humility and humbleness is liked by Allah. That we acknowledge our weakness in front of Him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inshallah be willing to forgive us for our mistakes and will overlook that. So dear friends, these are the beautiful 6 du'as that I've shared with you. 2 to be recited and supplicated rather, I should say, before iftar. And then the 4 of them after we finish breaking our fast. On your way out, please make sure you take this and make a habit starting from today if you didn't have already. So read it, share it with your family and friends, take as many as you want, spread it amongst your neighbors. You know, we have limited brothers who are coming here, but we have a lot of these. So these they just got printed for the month of Ramadan. Kindly take that and spread that as well, inshallah. And you'll get the reward of the du'as that these brothers are doing. Where did we start off today's discussion with? We talked about the fact that these Jum'as, this is the first. Before you know it, we'll be attending the last. Before we know it, it'll be like this, kalamh al-basar. Like a blink of an eye will go away. We want to make sure we relish every moment. We want to make sure that Jum'ah especially is relished. And the best way to relish that, to ensure that your relationship with Allah is increasing, is that you see that you enjoy dua. Okay, then how do I know my spirituality is increasing? See, do you enjoy making dua or not? Has that level of enjoyment increased or not? The duration of dua, has that increased or not? So with that, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala, we hope that Allah, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, makes this month for all of us a month of dua. And that we pour our heart out in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, individually as well as collectively. Alhamdulillah, here at Darul Salam, every single day, 25 minutes before Maghrib Salah, we have dhikr and dua. You can come in person. We invite you. There's iftar here as well. And if you're not able to come in person, you can just go to our YouTube Masjid DS channel and listen from there. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept everyone's duas. Let us stand up and perform our sunnah salah. Some announcements, inshallah. We have tonight our first Brothers Youth Qiyam. Alhamdulillah, we're so blessed and pleased to share this great news that we are having special youth programs along with all our other programs in the blessed month of Ramadan. We'll have Imam Asfaruddin from IFN Libertyville Masjid, who will be addressing the youth. And then we'll have basketball, Qiyam, and Suhoor as well. So please share this message with all the youth to be here after their own tarawis or pray tarawih here with us tonight. And the program will begin around 11 p.m. and it will be available all the way till Fajr, inshallah. This is going to be every Friday night at Darul Salam for the youth. Secondly, we have daily programs taking place here. After Asr, Friday through Sunday, we have Imam Mawlana Zahid Chaudhry giving a dars here after Asr. And then daily before Maghrib, 25 minutes before Maghrib, we have dhikr and dua. Similarly, we have tarawih taking place here. 29 day in the masjid, 29 day in the gym, 7 day in the banquet hall, and then about another 7 tarawees in the various classrooms, alhamdulillah, some 15 days, some 20 days, some 25 days. We're so blessed to have this amazing environment, alhamdulillah, being provided for all of us. So there's tafsir taking place after the tarawees over here, one in the masjid and one in the banquet hall. But you can join that or listen online if you're not praying here. We have a special zakat workshop taking place next Sunday, April 25th. And we'll have, additionally, every day, Monday through Sunday, there's a special sisters program with Alima Nikhat Muqeem in the new women's prayer hall. Alhamdulillah, it's from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. every single day, where they recite Quran, go over some tafsir of the Quran, and recite the Hizb al-Azam together, an explanation of that. It's a really great program for our sisters. Please share that message with the women of the community, inshallah. Those of you who are interested in doing i'tikaf, be it the full sunnah 10 days, or a shorter nafil i'tikaf based on your work schedules, you can go to the website masjiddiyas.org/i'tikaf2021 and register for that. Vaccines are required for that. So please, if you need help in the vaccination as well, reach out to the masjid. We are partnering up with various brothers here who are facilitating it, especially for those who are doing i'tikaf, as well as the general community. And additionally, we have job opportunities here at Darul Salaam for teaching positions in the high school. So if anyone is interested or know anyone's interested, please do check our website, inshallah, for the various job opportunities. Lastly, I want to take a couple minutes here to remind everyone that before 2 months ago, we started a campaign called The Fortunate 1400. You have heard about this before, probably. And this is a campaign of getting families and individuals to become patrons of this institution on a monthly basis, perpetually, to support the work that, alhamdulillah, is happening over here. The proof is in the pudding. You come here, you know exactly what's happening. You come in the evening to look at the programs, visit the building, alhamdulillah, attend the lectures and the programs, listen online. And alhamdulillah, I know all of you are benefiting and enjoy the programs that are happening. This all requires support and investment from all of us, our time as well as our wealth. So we are looking for 1,400 families and individuals on a monthly basis perpetually to support the institution. Be it $100, be it $200, be it $500, be it $50, whatever it is. So if you have not already signed up in this blessed day of Jummah, I'm requesting you, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala, to please consider signing up. We are about 20%, 15-16% of our goal. We are hoping to get this done by the Khatm al-Quran night, by the end of this month. And I need everyone's help. Not only to yourself become a partner in it, but also, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala, share this message with others as well. So there are pledge cards on the way out. There's the kiosks here as well in the lobby. With just a show of hands, may I ask, inshallah, who are those individuals who would like to participate? If they have not already joined this campaign, would like to join the Fortunate 1400, just show of hands, inshallah. Who are those individuals? Mashallah. I just want to make dua for you, brother. What's your name? Sean. Ji, mashallah. Your name again? I can't hear. Islam, mashallah. By Sean, by Islam, who else, inshallah? Who else is here, inshallah, wants to join the campaign? Mashallah. Name, brother? Hussein, brother Hussein. Mashallah, Hussein Jalu. Yes, who else? Who else is not? Yes, uncle, your name? Akhtar uncle, mashallah. Who else, inshallah? Which other individual here would like to participate? Gee, just give it to the brothers here. Just keep your hands raised, he'll just give you the pledge card. Which other brother or sister here who's listening to me says, inshallah, they would like to join it? Whatever level you're comfortable with. But just join this campaign, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala, on a monthly basis. I know many of you have been giving. But for those who are not, who are here first time, or who haven't gotten a chance to sign up, or would like to sign up, especially in the month of Ramadan, I'm asking you, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala, that you have a share. I know some of you have come back after a long time to the masjid, but guess what? If you've been a monthly donor, you're getting the full reward of what is happening here based on your intention. That's the beauty of it, that we may not be able to come every day, but if you are participating on a regular basis, on a monthly basis, perpetually, then alhamdulillah, we'll be getting the reward. Who else is there, inshallah? Just with a show of hands, just raise your hand, and the brother, inshallah, will give him the pledge card there, inshallah. So we'll have this campaign running throughout Ramadan. I hope, with all of your du'as, we can complete it by the month of Ramadan. We're only 18% there, so we need some more individuals. If there are brothers who would like to sign up for, say, 1,000 a month or 500 a month, that will, of course, take up 5 people's spot. So I would encourage those who have, sign up on behalf of every individual in our home. Whether it's 25, whether it's 10, whether it's 100, on behalf of your wife, your son, your daughter, your mom and dad, those who've passed away, those who are alive, as a sadaqah jari. I know one mother, mashallah, today, she donated towards food in another country. And she said, I want to do it on behalf of every son and every daughter and their husbands and wives, right? On herself, she wanted to do that on behalf of sadaqah jariyah and protection for her kids. So I would encourage all of us to do the same. Whatever amount it is, do it on behalf of every single member of your household. And inshallah, they will be receiving that reward directly in their book of deeds. And my dear friends, I want to share with you an incident that happened yesterday here. A brother came up to me, he said, Mufti Sahib, I want to share an incident. And I hope he doesn't mind because I'm not giving his identity here. He said, I had a dream that my wife is going to get very sick and she's going to get, you know, in a really bad situation. And, you know, her life is in danger. And then in that same dream, I see that you're fundraising. And I'm coming and giving you the donation money. And alhamdulillah, you know, that's how the dream ended. So he said, in the next day, my wife got extremely ill, was rushed to the ER. And unfortunately, a very horrible procedure was to take place, which would pretty life-changing, life-altering procedure would have had to happen based on her situation. But he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped. Last moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved her from having that procedure, which would change her life forever. And he said, I realized this was a sign from Allah, and here's a check. I said, subhanAllah, how blessed you are. Some people don't get it. Some people just don't see stuff. Allah throws them a slap from to the right, to the left. They still don't wake up. They still don't wake up. But then there's certain individuals where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just sends them a small signal through a dream. And they realize that, subhanAllah, this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this calamity will be averted and has been averted through sadaqah. And that's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. That give shifa to your sick through sadaqah. Dawu mardakum sadaqah. That's one hadith. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said that sadaqah is something that a calamity cannot overtake. So if you're having any type of physical, emotional, spiritual, mental difficulty in your life, push that away and treat yourself through sadaqah. Anywhere, whether here or somewhere else, but definitely give in this blessed month. We'll be making this appeal throughout the month. I ask you, inshallah, tabarak wa ta'ala, to continue to remain generous the way Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. And if you haven't prayed tarawih here, please do. And it should bring smile to your face, because this is all of your efforts to see this beautiful seminary and community center up and about, and just the beautiful vibe, alhamdulillah, that's here in the night. It's awesome, and you all should feel proud and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you all participated in that. And without your participation, this would not have been possible. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue to inspire this community, for all of us to be able to be elite, you know, an example, an exemplary community for across the brothers and sisters across the United States. And may Allah preserve and protect all of you, your wealth, your health, your families, and this institution from all evil. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون وقال تعالى وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد ورضى اللهم عن جميع الصحابة والصحابيات خاصة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله عنهم وأرضاه اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين وانصر المستضعفين من المسلمين في كل مكان عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقيم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حيا على الصلاة حيا على الصلاة حيا على الفلاح حيا على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن شاء الله we have brother Regis be taking the shahada after the salah alhamdulillah we had someone take the shahada after the first salah and now as well after the remaining after the jumah inshallah Make sure heels are on the blue line. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Maliki Yawm Al-Din. Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'een. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والليل إذا يغشى والنهار إذا تجلى وما خلق الذكر والأنثى فإن سعيكم لشتى فأما من أعطى واتقى وصدق بالحسنى فسنيسره لليسرى وأما من بخل واستغنى وكذب بالحسنى فسنيسره للعسرى وما يغني عنه ماله إذا تردى إن علينا للهدى وإن لنا للآخرة والأولى فأنذرتكم نارا تلظى لا يصلاها إلا الأشقى الذي كذب وتولى وسيجنبها الأتقى الذي يؤتي ماله يتزكى الله
سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين الذي يؤتي ماله يتزكى وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى ولسوف يرضى الله سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر الله أكبر
As Brother Rigas comes up, I would like to also make a short dua here. Unfortunately, right before Jummah, we got the very sad news of one of our esteemed colleagues, Maulana Muhyi, who teaches the post-Fajr talk here. Many of you benefit from his talks here. His father just passed away right before Jummah. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So let's make dua of forgiveness for them and all the those who have passed away from the ummah, and dua of shifa for those who are sick. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma anta salamun ka salam. Dua ta'idha al-jalali wa ikram. Allahumma laka al-hamdu kulluhu wa laka al-shukru kulluhu. Allahumma la nasi thana'in alayka antika ma'athnita ala nafsik. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وأنثانا اللهم من أحييته منا فأحيي عن الإسلام ومن توفيته منا فتوفه على الإيمان اللهم اغفر له وارحمه واعف عنه ونقه من الذنوب كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم اجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعل حفرة من حفر النار اللهم لا تحرمنا أجره ولا تفتنا بعده وأبدله دارا خيرا من داري وأهلا خيرا من أهلي اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين وانصر المستضعفين من المسلمين في كل مكان ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلق محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Please do not forget to take the card on your way out, the dua card from the archway.
Brother Rigas, you can repeat after me in Arabic and then in English. Is that fine? We'll take the official declaration of accepting Islam. Alhamdulillah, you've studied it, you learned about it. Now it's here on this blessed day of Jummah in front of this crowd as a witness. Repeat after me. Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
An. La.
La.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illal.
Illa.
La.
Wa.
Wa ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Anna.
Annam.
محمد
محمد
عبده
عبده
و ورسوله
رسول
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 له
له
I bear witness that there is no deity besides Allah
besides Allah
and I bear witness
and I've been witness
that Muhammad
that Muhammad
is his servant,
in his servant,
and his messenger,
and this messenger.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu right. Akbar.
We learn from the hadith that the Prophet said, "Inna al-Islam yahdimu ma kana qablahu." Islam wipes away everything that happened before that. So today, we give a very warm welcome to Brother Regas and share with him the congratulations of the fact that all the past life, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala has forgiven those sins, and we hope on this blessed day of Jum'ah and in Ramadan, through his accepting Islam, that Allah forgives us as well. Jazakumullah khair.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا ما بعد. A very warm welcome to everyone in this first blessed Jum'ah of the month of Ramadan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah. We have been so blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be able to congregate like this on the day of Jum'ah in Ramadan. And we ask Allah to allow us to continue to remain connected to His house. Ameen. Dear friends, the blessed month we waited for in anticipation for such a long time. And as quickly as it started, we're seeing the days go by real fast. And here we go, there's a few hours left in the first Jum'ah. And before we know it, the second and the third and the fourth will come and the month will end. So in order for us to fully benefit from this month, we have to put brakes on our life. And we have to slow down and try to enjoy and relish every moment. And the example is that if someone with much effort makes a very beautiful dessert and a very expensive one and presents it, and he wants you to sit there and enjoy it, comment on it, look at it and so forth, and then every single bite, enjoy it. But if a person closes his eyes and just shoves that whole piece of dessert down their mouth, the full effect of it is not going to be there. Because the enjoyment starts simply by looking at it and then smelling it, thinking about it, small bites and tastes of it. Every single aspect of the texture and the moisture and the sweetness of it and the tanginess of it or whatever it may be is enjoyed by the taste buds. Ramadan is not just a slice of cake. Ramadan is this amazing moment filled with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rahmah in every direction. And so we cannot allow ourselves to blindly plow through this month, but instead constantly keep on stopping ourselves and pinching ourselves. By what day is this? This is the fourth day of Ramadan. What is this? This is the day of Jum'ah. Constantly telling us, asking ourselves, where was I last year at this time? Where were we praying Jum'ah last year? What was the condition of our Taraweeh last year? And how blessed we are, subhanAllah. So when we keep on repeating this and keep on asking ourselves this, we will hopefully be able to appreciate the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you and I are enjoying. And one of the best and most important ways to spend this blessed month is in supplicating and dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At every given moment, when you're driving, when you're sitting, when you're at home, wherever you are, asking Allah, Ya Allah, this is my need. Ya Allah, you become happy with me. Ya Allah, grant me shifa. Oh Allah, take care of my mother. Oh Allah, make me debt free. Oh Allah, grant me a better position. Oh Allah, grant me a pasiha. Constantly turning to Allah in dua, there is no better form of showing humility and humbleness to Allah than dua. My dear friends, if we want to ask ourselves, what degree of ruhaniya and spirituality have I gotten in my life? You can answer this yourself. How much do we enjoy dua? What degree do we enjoy dua? And how willing are we to raise your hands and ask? On our own, collectively, everyone's raising their hand, okay, we'll go along with that. But on our own, how much time do we spend dedicating to dua? My friends, praying salah is even not that hard. Dua on your own, you're not going to raise your hands and ask unless you believe He is there listening to you. Unless you have this conviction that the Supreme Being is listening to me and will answer me. That's the only thing that's going to make you wake up at 3:30 and raise your hands and ask Him. That's the only thing that's going to make you dedicate last 30 minutes before the end of the fast to sit in your room or in the masjid and supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what the ummah needs. The ummah needs you and I to raise your hands and make dua. We are going through so many difficulties, and the pandemic has made it even worse. In many countries where there are Muslims in large numbers, including in India, the lockdown is taking an effect, especially in the night. No lockdown during the day. In the night it happens. And so now most areas are not allowing more than 5 people to perform salah. I have spoken recently to some ulama there, and they were just telling me how horrible the condition is. There are festivals taking place where two and a half million people of other faiths are gathering openly. But the nighttime, 7 p.m., curfew. No more than 5 people can come to a salah.
We can see obviously what was happening here. And here we are able to come in as many numbers as we want for Taraweeh. Pray in one hall, pray in the other hall, pray outside, pray upstairs, downstairs, out, wherever you want, with ease and comfort. Come for any Jum'ah you want. No one's asking anything. Don't you think we have to be having our head down in gratitude to Allah all day and all night? And thanking Him. And don't you think that it's a right of those people upon us that we make dua for them? Those who had at least Jum'ah, I always think Jum'ah is a place where you come to cry. Masjid is a place where you come and shed your tears when everyone else gave up on you and you find all the doors closed. The masjid is the place where we come and find solace and comfort. But if the masjid is also closed, then where do you go? So it is our duty as Muslims in this country, with open doors available for us, that we make dua for all our brothers and sisters in whatever part of the world they're going through difficulty in. And so today, on the blessed day of Jummah, I ask you to be part of those group of people who will dedicate time throughout the remainder of the day, and especially before Maghrib. Dedicate yourself to supplicating. You, on your way in, you may have seen this dua card that was shared with you. And on the way out, please pick it up if you haven't, and take as many copies as you can and share it with all of those neighbors of yours and maybe people wherever you're performing Taraweeh. If you're not performing Taraweeh over here, take it with you. These are some prophetic duas that are to be recited at the time of iftar. When we are breaking our fast, first thing we should be saying is in the name of Allah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The second thing, second dua that's mentioned here, Allahumma inni as'aluk, O Allah, I ask you, bi rahmatika, in the name of your mercy, allati wasi'at kulla shay, that encompasses everything. In the name of your mercy that is greater than all our sins, right? Greater than all of us and all our mistakes. That mercy, Allah Himself says in the Quran, wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay, and my mercy is encompassing of all things. So all things means me and my sins. I'm included in shay. So I say, oh Allah, I ask you in the name of that mercy which encompasses everything, an taghfir li, that you forgive me. This is the dua we should recite before we put the date in our mouth. Along with our various personal duas, this is the dua that we should be reciting. Then, once a person breaks his fast, you're going to finish what is we call the iftari part of it, and then you're going to pray your maghrib before you have dinner. Right after you finish eating and before you go for your maghrib, these are the next four duas that have been mentioned in the hadith. And let's go through that. First one, ذهب الظم. We say, O Allah, ذهب الظم, my thirst is gone. وابتلت العروق, my body is nourished. My veins, literally my veins are moistened. Meaning my body is nourished after eating. وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله. And if Allah wills, the reward of my good deed has been established, has been written. We're hoping, we can't say for certainty, but we hope that our actions, although they're filled with flaws and weaknesses, Allah Azza wa Jal will be writing the reward of 1, 2, 3, 4, and now 5 fasts. The second dua, Allahumma laka sumt. O Allah, I fasted, but who did I fast for? Laka, for you. Because it's easy for us to break the fast when people are not around us. It's very easy. Why would a person remain thirsty and hungry? He's got football practice, basketball practice, he's got work, he's working out, in somewhere in the heat, in the sun. Why is he not breaking his fast? Because he didn't fast for you and I, he fasted for Allah. So, Allahumma laka sumtu, Allah, I fasted for you. Now, I'm about to break my fast, or I've already broken my fast, but with what? Wa ala rizqika aftartu. I've broken my fast with the sustenance that you have given me. If it wasn't, I fasted for you and I broke my fast also for you. That's the teachings of the Prophet ﷺ. When adhan is called for Maghrib, we should not delay. We should immediately break our fast. Make all the dua you want from Asr to Maghrib. But Maghrib time, don't delay. Break your fast. The third dua, Alhamdulillah alladhi a'anani. All praise belongs to Allah. A'anani, who has assisted me. What has He done? How did He assist me? Fasumtu, hence I fasted. How many people here sitting here know individuals who were scared when Ramadan was coming? They said, "Bhai, kaisa roza rakhenge? We're diabetic, we're fulan, we got this issue, that issue. We don't know how we're going to fast." And now, mashallah, we're in the first week, and alhamdulillah, we're able to fast. We're able to actually come for Taraweeh and stand for, 20 rakats. If you look at the 7-day khatam that we're taking place here in the banquet hall led by Maulana Yusuf, vast majority of people are senior citizens, right? Where are they getting that taqa? Where are they getting that strength? From Allah. Allah gives them that spiritual, which turn becomes physical strength to fast also and to stand up in qiyam for hours. So we're thanking Allah, Ya Allah, I thank you for giving me the strength. Fasumtu, so hence I fasted. Warazaqtani, and you've now provided me. فأفطرت, so I've broken my fast. So in my fasting, I'm doing it because you have enabled me. And in my breaking my fast, I'm also doing it because you've given me sustenance. In every aspect of my life, I owe it to you. And the last dua, اللهم لك الصمنا. Oh Allah, we have fasted for you. We all have fasted for you. وعلى رزقك أفطرنا. And oh Allah, we've broken our fast with your sustenance. فتقبل منا. Oh Allah, so please accept it from us. إنك أنت السميع العليم. You're all hearing, all knowing. This is taken obviously from the Quranic dua of Ibrahim عليه السلام. When Ibrahim عليه السلام and his son Ismail عليه السلام, father and son, son is going to become a prophet as well. Father is known as Nabi Sallam called him Abi, my father. Nabi Sallam is calling him my father, Khalilullah, the friend of Allah. That individual with his son are building the Kaaba, the most, I mean, building a masjid. We talk about the reward of building. We talk about vacuuming the masjid. We talk about spending $100 to support the masjid. It's so rewarding. Imagine you and your son physically build the Kaaba. What could be more virtuous than that? But what is his dua after he does it? He says, Rabbana, oh my Lord, taqabbal minna. Accept it from us. Now, I want to say something about the word taqabbal. Taqabbal, my dear friends, comes from the root word qaf ba lam, qabila. Qabila means to accept. This qabila, you hear this in marriage. When the nikah and aqd takes place, you say qabiltuha. Right? I've accepted her. That means it is what it is. This is my wife and I accept this proposal. But taqabbal, if I say taqabbaltuha, it's a whole different meaning. Taqabbaltuha means I don't want to accept it. It's not worthy of acceptance, but I'm just looking the other way and accepting it. That's the meaning, what we call takalluf. The meaning of takalluf is intrinsic to the scale of tafa'ul. Hence, taqabbul means, oh Allah, this action of mine is not worthy of acceptance. I'm asking you to cast, do not look at all my flaws and faults in this good deed of mine, and then just accept it based on your generosity and not what I deserve. Subhanallah. That's part of the actual word. So that's what Ibrahim and Ismail did with Allah. And say, Ya Allah, this Kaaba, the way we built it, and me and my son, we're not where we're supposed to be. That's the humility of these prophets. Imagine where you and I stand. Where's building the Kaaba and where's my, you know, hole ridden fast? So hence, this is how we end our day. فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Allah, accept it even though it's not worthy of acceptance. Allah loves humility. We're all sinners. We're all sinners. But some of us choose to repent and some of us choose not to repent. So why not become from amongst those in this blessed month that we constantly be asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for not only acceptance of our fast, but also constantly be repenting. My dear friends, when it comes to today's talk, as I went over through these du'as, pick them up on your way out, I'm emphasizing the aspect of du'a. I want to say one thing else. Many times we don't know what to ask. If I say, brothers, let's make 20 minutes dua. And I really, really wish we could have that. In Etikaf, inshallah, we'll have a program like that. We usually do. We do collective dua and like, all right, now 15 minutes, all of us do our own thing. This is a homework time, classwork. We're going to do homework together. Every one of us, we have to face Allah, face towards the Qibla and make our dua. We have to get a habit of it. But some of us may be thinking, but what am I supposed to do for 20 minutes? My friend, the thing is, why are you thinking you don't know for 20 minutes? Because you haven't thought about your life properly. If you think about how many issues are stuck in your life, of your mom's life, your dad's life, your spouse's life, your children's life, your future spouse's life, your business, your job, your future, your grave, your akhirah, your home, your business, the ummah in every country, in every continent, there's an endless list. 20 minutes, 200 minutes won't be enough, 2,000 minutes won't be enough if you start. The issue is we haven't gotten a habit of asking. So instead of going up in front, have you ever been waiting in the drive-through line and the guy in front of you sitting there taking forever to choose what donut he wants to eat, to take? It's like, come on, man, come on. Just, why are you wasting time? This 30 seconds, get your coffee, don't move on. You plan it, you know it beforehand what you want to get. You're asking Allah. Allah is descending to the first heaven every single night. In the month of Ramadan, He's closer to us than ever. At iftar time, He's waiting. Jummah time, He's waiting. Between the two khutbahs, He's waiting. After Salah, He's waiting. And now we're thinking, scratching our head, oh, what should I ask? That's not smart. The way to do it is we write a list from beforehand. That this month, my key thing is, these are 10 or 15 items I need to get done by the end. By Eid time, I got to get this done. So every day, I'm going to be making dua for these things. And you write that down. That's what I had the students over here do. I told them, listen, I want you to write down 15, 20, 30 items. Not only once, but more importantly, traits that you're not happy about. Qualities that you're not proud about. Characteristics that you are ashamed of. mistakes, sins, major, minor, bad habits. Make a list of those. And then every single day, you're going to turn to Allah and ask, Ya Allah, purify this from me, purify this from me, purify this from me. And by the end of the month, inshallah, you'll be a different individual. All of those evils that we all have, I have and we all have, they need to be first written down. We have to have it in our mind. And then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove that from us. And you'll see what an amazing Ramadan this will be. So I encourage all of us to please join me in this campaign of dedicating time for dua every day and coming up with a list ourselves of the needs that we have, the wants, whatever it is. And there's no greater want and need than being forgiven from Allah and earning His pleasure. We ask Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes this Ramadan genuinely the most special one for all of us and allows us to make value every moment, every second. And may He make us amongst those who earnestly make dua for Him excessively. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Let us stand up inshallah and perform our sunnah salah. Some important announcements, inshallah. Tonight will be the first of four youth qiyams at Darul Salam. We have every Friday night a guest speaker. Tonight's guest speaker will be Imam Asfaruddin from IFN, the Imam of Libertyville Masjid. After Tarawih, we'll have our tafsir, and then inshallah he'll be addressing the youth, followed by basketball, sports, and suhoor. This program is available here till Salatul Fajr. Please spread the word, all the youth. If you're hearing me right now, we want to see you, inshallah, here tonight. If you usually don't come or you pray somewhere else, please do come at least tonight, inshallah, on Friday nights and join the youth night here at Darul Salam. Daily, these are the rundown of the programs we have. Salatul Fajr is at 4:45 a.m. And we have a short khatira, a few minutes after Fajr, every day. after Asr on the weekends, starting from today, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we have a lecture and a lesson, dars by Maulana Zahid Chaudhry, Sheikh Zahid Chaudhry here, Friday to Sunday. And every evening, 25 minutes before the Maghrib Adhan, I lead a dhikr here, followed by dua. So you can join here in person or join online through our Masjid DS YouTube channel. And alhamdulillah, every day we have iftar arrangements here for both men and women. You can join, inshallah, whenever you would like to. So, and then after Isha, we have the Taraweeh, the 29-day Taraweeh in the Masjid, the normal full-day khatam. There's a 29-day in the gym that I'm leading separately there. There's a 7-day one in the banquet hall. And then many classrooms, maybe another 8 or 9 classrooms, have their own 20-day, 25-day, 15-day different khatams. Alhamdulillah, we're blessed this year to have 10 different Taraweehs taking place simultaneously with different qira'at, in different modes of recitation, alhamdulillah. This is a huge gift of Allah for this community and for all of us, alhamdulillah, to be able to witness such a blessed Ramadan over here at Darussalam. Additionally, the i'tikaf, we're going to have sunnah and nafil i'tikaf this year. If you're interested in signing up, please get your vaccine and go to masjidds.org/i'tikaf2021. There are just a few slots left. So please, if you're interested in joining i'tikaf, do so. There are also a number of opportunities to serve at Darussalam as a teachers here in the high school positions are available. Please check the website if you're interested, inshallah, and apply as soon as possible. And also, we have 2 daily tafsirs after Isha that are live streamed and are also available here in person. One in the masjid, one in the gym, and one in the banquet hall. So you can attend those and benefit from those as well. There's a lot of space here for Taraweeh. So I request you, those brothers who are maybe not comfortable because of space in their own areas, let them know. Sisters as well. There's a lot of space, alhamdulillah, for sisters with kids and just women. Spread the word so inshallah they can come in and have a comfortable Taraweeh here, inshallah. And last but not least, a couple months ago, we started a campaign here at Darussalam once as we saw the seminary and the community center was about to get completed, that we requested the brothers that just like we all pooled our resources together and Allah used this whole community to build this beautiful institution, that we need individuals to continue to support the institution as well on a monthly basis at any amount. And that's where the campaign started, the Fortunate 1400. Just like there were 1400 Sahaba who participated with Rasulullah in the year of Hudaybiyah and they pledged their allegiance with him and supported him and Allah revealed verses about them in Surah Fatih. We need 1400 individuals and families to similarly take on the responsibility of supporting this institution with a monthly donation. $50, $100, $1,000, whatever you can. So I want a very quick show of hands of those brothers who are already part of this. Can you just raise your hand if you're already part of this? Hi. Alhamdulillah. MashaAllah. Alhamdulillah. So every Jummah we have brothers, alhamdulillah, who are part of it. So those of us who have not heard about this, who haven't been able to participate, on this first day of Jummah, I'm asking you, inshallah, to join at any level. And I'm not asking you only to join on behalf of yourself. I want you to join on behalf of your son, daughter, your daughter-in-law, son-in-law, your mom and dad, alive or have passed away. Sign them up. If you want to give 100, give 25 on behalf of each one. You want to give 500, give 100 on behalf of each member of the family. So that each one of them, inshallah, can have a share. So let's have a quick show of hands. We're going to do this campaign. We're about 16% towards our goal. Our goal is to have this done by the end of this month. So we'll need a lot of assistance and Allah's help, most importantly. So I'm asking, inshallah, can we have a quick show of hands? Who would like to join this Fortunate 1400 today, in today's Jummah? Being the first one here, mashallah, takbir, Dr. Anis here, alhamdulillah, mashallah, Dr. Sab in the back here. Mashallah. All right, mashallah, youngster over there. Geez, 3 people, 4. Adam bhai, right here, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. Who else, inshallah? Just raise your hands, inshallah. MashaAllah. Here, front, one in front. Here, inshallah. Give to this brother over here. Alhamdulillah. Who else, inshallah? Just quickly raise your hands and we'll make a collective dua at the end. Who else, inshallah, would join at any level? Sisters, brothers, in the side prayer hall, in the lobby. Just raise your hand, inshallah, at any level that you want to participate in the Fortunate 1400. I want to share an incident that just happened 2 days ago. A brother came to me after Taraweeh. He said, I want to share something with you. I said, what happened? He said, I had a dream a few days ago that my wife is going to get very ill, very sick, and it's going to be a very dangerous situation. And then I had a dream that you're fundraising and that I'm giving you sadaqah. I said, SubhanAllah, I haven't done a fundraiser yet. This is my first one. So I said, what happened? He said, as soon as I woke up, the very next day, my wife became very ill, was rushed to the hospital, and a life-changing procedure would have to take place, which would pretty much alter the future of her life forever, a sickness. And he said, SubhanAllah, Allah was so merciful, last minute, that was averted, and alhamdulillah, she came back without having to go through that route. And he said, here's the sadaqah that Allah showed me in the dream giving. And I said, SubhanAllah, you're so lucky that Allah subhanAllah gave you that warning beforehand and also taught you how to get out of this mess. Because Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam already said, "Dawu mardakum sadaqah," treat your sick people through sadaqah. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, sadaqah is such a shield that difficulty cannot overcome it. So my dear friends, let's take a heed from this and give sadaqah for each one of our children, each one of our siblings, each one of our parents, be it alive or passed away. Any other brothers who are motivated, inshallah, on this first day of Jum'ah and would like to participate, who have not, just quickly raise your hand, inshallah. There you go, mashallah. Who else, mashallah? One brother right there, Abdul Hadi Bhai, right behind you. MashaAllah. Who else, inshallah? Raise your hand. MashaAllah. Taqabbalallah. Gee, who else, inshallah? Keep your hand raised, brother. Inshallah. At any level you want to give, we'll make this call throughout Fridays, inshallah. And we hope we can reach this goal through Allah's fadl. Who else, inshallah? The lobby. Brothers in the lobby. The brothers in the side prayer hall. You know, there's individuals here with kiosks, there's pledge cards. Just take that on your way out, fill it out, and just turn it into the office, inshallah. So, those of you who heard me, alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all those who signed up today and all those who signed up before. Say ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way they're taking care of this madrasa, this masjid and seminary, may Allah take care of their homes. May Allah take care of their parents. May Allah take care of their children. May Allah take care of their progeny. May Allah give all these individuals today and the past, whoever have supported in any way, shape or form, may Allah give them the full reward of every khair and good that happens from this podium and from this madrasa and this community center. May Allah make every good action that takes place in this entire madrasa and seminary in the mizan hasanat of these individuals. Say ameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow this community to be an exemplary community for the entire United States. May Allah shower His countless blessings upon all of us in this masjid and allow us to be protected from hasad, from evil eye, from shaitan, from the nafs. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us united, keep our ranks together. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullahu khairah. So this is a campaign that's going on. I request you to please pick up the dua card as well as a pledge card and share it in the community and help us reach our goal by Khatm al-Quran night. Barakallahu feekum. And inshallah, after Jum'ah, Mawlana Farhan will be leading here. I want you all to please make dua. We have a very sad news that just came in right before Jum'ah. One of our colleagues, and he taught all of you here, he gives a dars here after Fajr, Mawlana Muhyi, who's been a teacher here for many years, his father suddenly just passed away right before Jum'ah, Mawlana Muhyi Khan, some of you know from the Elgin community. So please make dua for maghfirah. Allah forgive him. And inshallah, the janazah details will be shared as soon as we get to know about it, the dua will be made after Jum'ah. Jazakumullah khairah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فيا أيها الناس وحدوا الله فإن التوحيد رأس الطاعات واتقوا الله فإن التقوى ملاك الحسنات وعليكم بالسنة فإن السنة تهدي إلى الطاعة ومن أطاع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى وإياكم والبدعة فإن البدعة تهدي إلى المعصية ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى وعليكم بالإحسان فإن الله يحب المحسنين ولا تتبعوا الدنيا فتكونوا من الخاسرين ألا وإن نفسا لن تموت حتى تستكمل رزقها فاتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب وتوكلوا عليه فإن الله يحب المتوكلين ودعوه فإن ربكم مجيب الداعين وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخلين بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى جواد كريم ملك بر رؤوف رحيم الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله قال الله تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد بعدد من صلى وصام اللهم صل على محمد بعدد من قعد وقام وصل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
أقيموا صفوفكم معتدلوا Please make sure your heels are on the blue tape Please make sure that you have your mask on at all times and it is covering your mouth and nose جزاك الله خيرا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله
سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ بعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
Inshallah, we'll make a dua for Maulana Muhi's father who passed away a short while ago, inshallah.
اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام تبارك ربنا وتعاليت هذا الجلال والإكرام اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وأنثانا اللهم من أحيته منا فأحيه على الإسلام ومن توفيته منا فتوفه على الإيمان اللهم اغفر له وارحمه وعافه واعف عنه وأكرم نزله ووسع مدخله واغسله بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقه من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم اجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعله حفرة من حفر النار رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي والمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب
سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.